Okay, scientist, you've got to help me out because I'm so confused. I know that fish have scales and this snake's body has scales on it, but this animal doesn't have gills, so it can't be a fish. If it's not a fish, what is it? And why do some animals have scales? Instead of feathers or fur, some animals have scales covering their body. Scales do three important things for an animal: provide protection, hold in moisture, and help with movement. Scales help protect animals from things that might hurt them, as if they are wearing a special suit of armor. For some animals, their scales are tough and can shield them from scratches, bites, or even other animals trying to eat them. Scales also help to hold in moisture or water by keeping it inside an animal's body so it doesn't get too dry in the hot sun. This is especially helpful for land animals who have scales. Fish don't have to worry as much about drying out since they are already underwater. Finally, scales help animals with movement or getting from place to place. The scales on fish, for example, help them glide through the water. The scales on this snake help it slide around on the ground since it doesn't have any legs. Just because an animal has scales doesn't mean it's a fish. Scales can be found on birds, reptiles, and even some mammals, like this pangolin. Amphibians are the only animal class who never have scales, so that means a snake is not an amphibian. But a snake is cold-blooded. So we know it can't be classified as a warm-blooded animal like a mammal or a bird. That means that this snake can only be one thing: a reptile. Besides having scales and being cold-blooded, what are some other characteristics of reptiles? Well, underneath their scales, reptiles have dry skin. Their skin stays very dry to help their scales hold moisture inside the animal's body. The dry skin is especially helpful to reptiles who live in very dry or hot places. Reptiles are able to go in the water, but unlike fish, they are born with lungs instead of gills. Although reptiles can either lay eggs or give live birth to their babies, most reptiles lay eggs. Their eggs are hard and leathery to provide protection and hold moisture inside the egg. Let's take a look at a few different animals and decide whether they are reptiles or a different class of animal. We can use this chart to help us decide. A crocodile. Let's see. A crocodile is a cold-blooded animal that can be found in water, but it doesn't always stay underwater. This must be because it has lungs instead of gills. It also has dry, scaly skin, crawls on four legs, and gives birth by laying leathery eggs. Is a crocodile a reptile? Yes! The next animal is a seahorse. A seahorse is a cold-blooded animal that has scaly skin as well, but it's hard to tell if it's dry or not because a seahorse lives underwater. A seahorse doesn't have any legs, but it does have gills, which means it's not a reptile. Do you know what we can classify a seahorse as? A fish, that's right. Last one, a turtle. Interesting. Turtles have shells that protect their bodies. The shell is sort of like a big set of dry scales. And look, their legs have scales too. Turtles also lay leathery eggs. Many turtles spend a lot of time in water, but they lay their eggs on land because they are animals with lungs, not gills. What animal type do you think turtles are? They're reptiles. Awesome! Now we know reptiles are a special class of animals that have dry scales and lungs, are cold-blooded, and can lay either eggs or give live birth. Wow! It's amazing how we can think about just a few characteristics to help us sort different animals into the proper classification. And we only have one classification left to learn about. I can't wait to explore more animals next time with you. Until then, remember, science is all around you. Hey, hey.